Punch for playing island. Would we have kept this if this was just forest? I think so. You know, we can't. I don't think we can keep this. Even if we draw land, like, we have four mana sources. I mean, the hand is fine if we draw forest, obviously, but definitely keep that. That is just a mana creature. All the blue decks. I think that's a bad thing generally for us. Especially because we don't have like the super explosive versions of the green deck. Okay. Actually. No, I'm gonna bottom that. Thing is, we have like a plenty of blue sources in our deck. Do we really want to just draw another land? I know we have a Jace Bellerin, but we have like a decent chance of just naturally drawing a blue source. No, oh, well, there you go. There you go. Seagate Oracle. Ooh, and I have the Green Sun Zenith in my hand. I'm in. Yes. Let's get a Breeding Pool here because we don't have any other plays. Look at that. It was a Wood Elves, a 2/2 Wood Elves. Uh-oh. We don't have a lot of interaction. We're just gonna get Splinter Twinned out. Splinter Twin is definitely a weakness for the ramp deck. Oh, just Glenolendra Archmage. Interesting. I guess they can play it next turn. So I should not play the Baloth and play anything else. Literally anything else. I can't Green Sun Zenith for anything great, though. I can get a Trigon Predator. So maybe it's better just to play Jace. And I think I want to activate the top first because I want to basically just prevent myself from drawing any more spells. Nice. So yeah, I don't want to draw the Harmonize. And I'll make it so that each player draws a card so that it won't die. I mean, I'm pretty sure my opponent's just going to go like Archmage land go, but still. So we don't have to top on upkeep because we're just going to draw the Wolfear Silverheart, which I think I'm just going to play. Boom! Yeah, nice Archmage. Oh, I messed up. Well, I mean, what I mean is, I don't want to draw that Harmonize. Oh, doesn't matter. Shucks. What I meant there was. I mean, blue-red, if my opponent doesn't steal it, like, has a pretty difficult time dealing with a Wolfear Silverheart. Famous last words. How's my opponent at 20? Oh, they block last turn. Oh, it's okay. We can cast spells this turn. That's nice. The thing is, though, is this like an upheaval turn? My opponent has a bunch of cards in hand. Does it, like, if I go, like, upheaval noble hierarch, like, how much ahead am I, even? I mean, upheaval land hierarch does seem pretty good. And I won't be able to resolve it later. And then I can go Green Sun Zenith too. Or actually, I can even go... I can even go like Jace turn too. And I don't think I need to be discarding more cards. I mean, there's a Stroke of Genius on top, but... Yeah, again, I don't... I guess I want to just find new cards outside of the Stroke, or do I want the Stroke? Like, I'm definitely going to go, like, Upheaval Land Hierarch, and then we're just kind of a million permanents in play. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I guess Stroke could be useful. No, I'm going to discard a Stroke. And I don't think I want to plus the Jace. I guess this is bad against like a Daze or something. Alright, so let's discard. Because I think I want everything to come into play untapped here. Discard Stroke, Temple, Forest. Forest. I gotta discard one more card. Everything else is good. So I don't know what else to discard. Because I want to probably go Green Sun Zenith next turn. Actually, no, maybe I go Shardless Agent. Shardless Agent can still hit a ramp card, so probably doing that, actually. What does Green Sun Zenith even get? Another ramp card? I guess this is like the most medium card in my hand. Like, if I go Shardless Agent into ramp, then I can play the Wolf Fear Silverheart. What the hell? That was not expected. Like, of all the cards, like, everything else made sense. And then, like, the Swift Spear came in. Yeah, so we can still hit like Avacyn's Pilgrim and Sylvan Caryatid off the Shardless Agent, which is what I think I'm interested in doing here. Oh, forgot about that guy too. Or Gal? Gal. All of the manas. Suspend Ancestral Vision. Okay. I'm okay with that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. All right. Yeah, let's go ahead and play Silverheart. You know what's actually pretty sick? I can put it on Devoted Druid and draw like a bunch of, use it to make a bunch of mana. Or do I want to just beat down for 6? Yeah, let's just beat down for 6. It is a cool thing to consider, though. That is nice. But my opponent, beat down for 7. Yeah. Pretty easy beat down for 7. Yeah, upheaval. Upheaval's good, turns out. If you were wondering. See at Oracle. Opponent not attacking. One, two, three, four, five, six. I can Green Sun Zenith for 6. So then I can get Dragonlord Dromoka. I can also get... I can't get Ophir Silverheart. Alright, well, first things first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah. The business and also the funk. Let's go. Not a lot of wraths I need to worry about in blue-red. Although, I guess the... getting Dragonlord Dromoka might be bad because my opponent can then steal it with Control Magic. No, if they steal it with Control Magic, I can still kill them with Wolfier Silverheart. Okay. Boom. All of the fat. We have all of the fat in play. You know, Kaiga might actually be reasonable here because they're playing blue-red. I mean... Old Man of the Sea also seems like it could be okay. I don't know. Old Man of the Sea at least gives us outs to, like, the combo. Like, the Splinter Twin combo, if they do have it. Faloth seems medium. I mean, I know they had a Monastery of Swift Spear, but their deck did not seem particularly aggressive. This does not seem good against Fire Ice. Could consider Kaiga. It's still kind of expensive. Let's just keep this as is. Like, I know Stroke is like super slow, but I feel like, you know, if I can somehow bait a bunch of counters and drag the game out, like, I can use this at some point. Sand is pretty slow, but we get to very likely go... Like, we're very likely to find a third land. So we can go, like, Oracle into Master of the Wild Hunt, which isn't terrible. And we still have, a Dungeon Geist, too. Like, we're on the draw with 2 lands, and one of the lands is a Scry land. So basically, if this isn't a ramp or creature, we're just going to bottom it. I mean, this is a good card and all, but... All right. I mean, it was basically like a Mulligan to 5, I guess. But, I mean, there's some utility to these cards later on. I guess there's a decent chance my Pilgrim dies here. Nope. Alright. Alright, well, if that's the case, let's just run out Master of the Wild Hunt. It forces an answer. Gives me the most value for playing it early. Dungeon Geist is also not bad. You can lock down a looter, but I mean, I feel like if my opponent had a removal spell, they probably would have killed my Pilgrim. Everybody knows you always bolt the board. I mean, that's just simple fact. Ancestral Vision. I'm gonna play the dungeon guys here first, actually. Trying to play around counters. And then if my opponent doesn't, clearly my opponent doesn't have a removal spell here, right? So if my opponent loots, then I can just kill the looter in response. Because if my opponent had a removal spell, they would have killed the wolf. Oh, that Swift Spear. Feels bad, man. We got baited. We got baited! If I kept it up, I would have been able to beat Pestermite. Not Deceiver Exarch, but... my opponent does have to just straight up have the combo, but they did loot. Oh my god! No! Darn. That sucks. Okay. Do I want Vapor Snag here? I feel like I just need more answers to the combo. I think maybe we just take out Shardless Agent, have Vapor Snag as an answer. Force Spike at that point can be decent here too. Oh man, that really feels bad. I think I'll cut top then. Let's go. I mean, go to six cards. That's what we'll do. Ah, man. That is unfortunate. So I bottomed that. We do have the three lands. We're just likely to draw another land. Also, I'd rather be able to find the ramp spell on turn two. Nice. It's okay. We can't really complain. Our hand's kind of getting there. Maybe this upheaval is... Well, it did win us the first game. Alright, now we're gonna take a land. Even if it's bad. Was that a turn 5 Splinter Twin? Yeah, it was. Don't do it to me. Don't do it to me. I mean, I think we harmonize. The thing is, I can't stop the Splinter Twin combo. My opponent, if I play opposition, they can just tap my Seagate Oracle and combo me out. So I think I want to develop my board here first. All right, don't kill me. Oh God. I mean, a turn two Magma Jet to the face usually means that they're looking for the combo. Oh, no, I do that. All right. Is it opposition time? Does that do it? I can tap the creature in response. I think it's up. Oh, God. I could also play Old Man of the Sea. I mean, my opponent didn't have the tapper that turn. If I play the opposition, I can tap down the island. And then I can just start playing things. Play around four spike, play the land. Alright. We didn't see a lot of counter magic from them, so. Okay. Okay. It resolved. Oh my god. It resolved. They found the creature. That's unfortunate. That is truly unfortunate. Don't play land. Or play Kiki Jiki. One or the other. Don't Splinter Twin me. Kiki Jiki me, okay? Just Kiki Jiki me. We tried our best here to play around the combo. I guess they found a Pestermite the turn after. Or they just didn't have the combo. Oh, Goblin Dark Dwellers. Okay, I'll force spike that. There's just too much value there. Too much value. Oh my god. My heart skipping many beats. Alright, untapped land would be great here so I can actually play both of my creatures. Okay, perfect. So let's play the old man first because that's the one I don't want to get dazed. Although my opponent doesn't have dazed, they would have dazed me already. Alright, alright, we got this. Ooh, why did I tap that one? Whatever. Alright. Simeon Spirit Guide, getcha. Flame Slash, alright. Alright, just give me some creatures here. Alright, fine. Fine. Head your way. Play Temple. Look for some creatures. Yeah. This is actually interesting. So I'd certainly want to tap this down. But, like, tapping down a mountain doesn't do a whole lot for Splinter Twin, whereas keeping this up is good against Splinter Twin. Exquisite Firecraft. Okay. Alright, I think the threat of the Splinter Twin combo is too great. And we don't have a whole lot going for us. So, I mean, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2. I think, I mean, Upheaval, Avacyn's Pilgrim seems totally fine. Because then we can go Avacyn's Pilgrim into Scry, into Seagate Oracle, into Opposition. Oh, and I guess they can tap it down. But again, we just don't have a whole lot. I guess I could, theoretically, I could wait one turn. Because that gives me 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 mana. So then I can go like Upheaval, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 mana. So I can go Upheaval, Pilgrim, Seagate Oracle. Or I guess maybe Upheaval Opposition is just better. All right, I'll wait then. I'll take two. Then I'll tap island. Because I'm going for the upheaval here. Alright, might as well get in for one. I want to tap down the island because my opponent can float a bunch, man, and play Pestermite after I upheaval. Alright. What do I want to do? Probably Seagate Oracle first. Seagate Oracle, Avacyn's Pilgrim. I think that's better than opposition. I mean, again, the other thing I can do is opposition and then play Avacyn's Pilgrim. If I guaranteed to resolve opposition, that's better for my future turns, but Seagate Oracle makes it so that I can set up a better draw. You know what? I'm going to go with Seagate Oracle. Look at that value. Upheaval just gave us just straight value. We'll do that. Play Avacyn's Pilgrim. And discard some goodies.
Hello.
Hello. And I guess we'll discard some basics. And we'll Green Sun Zenith next turn too. Because if we Green Sun Zenith next turn for a mana creature, then the turn 3 Pestermite won't actually stop us. Hmm. Actually, probably should discard one of these shock lands. Oh wait, I had an upkeep stop. So I can't get Noble Hierarch, but I can still get I can still definitely get Sylvan Caryatid. Alright. Well, we don't have a whole lot of action, so glad I still have this Scryland laying around. Oh, I guess I can't get Pestermite. Never mind. 1, 2, 3. Let's see. All right, so I definitely want to just go land opposition and tap down both two things. All right, the power of opposition, too strong. Whatever. I guess my opponent can play Pestermite in response to me tapping the lands. I would like to find a creature. Okay, well that was a creature. What can I get back? Oh, this was... That was a good draw. I'm not gonna lie. I can still tap two things if I play this. I don't want to get four spiked, so I guess I'll play one of these. So. Actually, I think I should just bash. You gotta finish the game somehow. Tapping down two lands seems like it's more than good enough. Alright, that was not bad. I can emblem, but I think I just, again, want to just keep putting the pressure on. I can get back another creature, but I can also just beat down for five. Yeah, I think I just want to keep adding to the board. Let's play the Devoted Druid here. Play Nature's Lore. Get a Forest. Scry. Put that on top. Wait, I probably shouldn't have put it on the blue. I probably shouldn't have animated the blue-green land. Alright, upkeep. I can actually tap two things. I can tap two things with the Devoted Druid. Because I can put a minus one counter on it and untap it. All right, so now we get to just attack for seven. I guess I can just play this two just to make sure. Oh no! I just that was a punt. I mean, we were gonna win that game, but that was a total punt. I forgot to Nissa, but it's okay. We still ended up winning off the power of upheaval. That card is insane in the ramp deck. I mean, we didn't even have a ton of ramp in our deck, but it was still like super important for some of our wins. Also, obviously, opposition is great. I think the best version of a ramp deck is blue green, and specifically just those two cards. If you want to splash blue, opposition and upheaval are just so powerful in this deck that it really just gives you game against a lot of other decks. Not only that, you can also draft counter magic and make it so that you have answers to, you know, things that the traditional mono green deck can't deal with. But there you have it, folks. Some Legacy Cube action. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next week.